Hey guys, VGamers and RV, you're back with another video, and today I'm back with some more Ni No Kuni Wrath of the White Witch. In the last episode, we did a bunch of errands and bounty hunts, and made our way here to Yule, the home of the Snow Folk, which you can see right there. And hopefully, we'll be able to continue on with our story today. Or at least that's the plan. We do have a couple of more bounty hunts or errands to do, I think. But we haven't been able to do those because we don't have the pieces of heart that we need. But we should get them now, here. Also, everyone is kind of shivering there. Obviously, because we don't have the clothes meant for the icy weathers here. So yeah, there's some pieces of heart we can steal. There's a couple of people who have errands for us. Oh, it's you again. Oh, it's you again. Alright, what do you need? What do you need, bro? Just tell me what you need. Three examples of how the climate of the Winter Isles affects the physiological development of indigenous creatures. The first travels atop a blue flower, the second is a proud creature that has found its niche in the glittering grotto, and the third piles snow upon its head. Okay. I have ideas as to which ones those, what creatures those are, but I don't know which one. Is it you? Is it you that has the piece of heart? I didn't see what piece of heart that they have. I didn't see the piece of heart that this old lady has. Oh, it's confidence. I'll take it. Alright. And then you have a quest, which I'll check on. You have something for me to take. Was it enthusiasm? I'm assuming it was enthusiasm. Just from, like, the bits and pieces of text that I actually managed to read there. Nope, it was courage. I thought it was enthusiasm. I mean, I guess you could... Can you mistake enthusiasm for courage? Maybe. And then there's someone over here who has a piece of heart. Is it you? I think it is you. It is you, right? Kindness? I think kindness, because there was something about knitting something for her grandma. I think that's kindness. Was kindness? Tell me it was kindness. Well, it could be enthusiasm. No, it couldn't be. It was kindness. Alright, sweet. We almost have a full locket now. That's crazy. We almost have a full locket now. And then... oh, we have one more over by Swift Solutions. So that may be our enthusiasm. This may be the enthusiasm we need to get the full locket. Is it our enthusiasm? I think it is the enthusiasm because there's so much going on there. Oh no, it was belief? There was a lot of explanation points in that conversation, so I assumed it was enthusiasm, but no, it's actually belief. And we do have... I think we only have one that we've never unlocked. Correct? We have one or two that we haven't... oh, it's two. Okay, we have these two that we haven't gotten yet. I think we all know what this one is, just from the shape. I think we can all tell what that is. So, there's that. But I think this is all we need for those other quests. So we can go back and do those. We actually need to go inside Swift Solutions, so let me go do that real quick. Since we actually need to go in here, either way. First things first, let me talk to you. There's a new bounty hunt that I'll take. No bounties to claim, no merit rewards to renew. And then, oh, hi, I'll talk to you in a second, buddy, because I need to talk to you to get... okay, those are all new quests from Yule, right? These are all Yule, and Yule. Alright, but a Tahiti community, so... confidence, kindness, and courage. We can go do those pretty quickly. I think we can go do those pretty quickly and then come back. One of them was a soldier in Ding Dong Dells. Another one was the brothers in Castaway Cove. And then it was someone in Tahiti, I believe. So we can go do these real quick, and then we could travel all the way back to Yule and take care of that. And hopefully this shouldn't take us too long, is the thing. Is that it really should not take us too long unless we get incredibly sidetracked by something, you know? If we get sidetracked by something, yeah, it's gonna take a while. There's also those creatures that Derwin asked for. Nope, that's the cauldron. Don't need to talk to you, buddy. That creatures that Derwin asked for. Oh, I forgot that this actually doesn't give me the details. I actually have to go talk to Derwin to get the details about what creatures he wanted. I forgot about that. But that's not a big deal. That's not a big deal. We can probably get those really easy. I'm pretty sure I know two of the creatures that he's talking about. I think I know two. I'm pretty sure I know two of the creatures that he's talking about. The third, I'm unsure of. I don't know what creature rests upon a blue flower. But I think the other two, I have an idea of which one they could be. So we can take care of that. We can take care of that during our storyline quest. Anyway, give heart. I forget what I need to give to you. Kindness? Was it kindness that I need to give to you? Courage. Courage is what I need to give to you. Why I need to give you courage, I don't remember, but here, you can take it. I don't remember why. Sergeant. Okay, I don't remember why I need to give this guy courage, but that was the thing. So, let me look at where we need to go next. Oh, wait, there's another one, Ding Dong Dell, right here. Perfect. It's the one over here. I forgot about you. I completely forgot about you. You need kindness. Yeah, no, I completely forgot about this chick. You're the one that needs kindness. Alright. I'm literally just spam clicking the A button so you can get through this a little bit faster. Alright, let me look back through here. Tahiti. And then there's Durin. Alright, so travel to the fairy grounds. And then we'll give the guy, what did you need? Confidence? I think you needed confidence. I'm gonna hope it was confidence because I don't remember what it was otherwise. I hope what you needed was, well, no matter what you needed, I'm pretty sure I have it. So I think it's you. Nope, it's a small dude over here. Give heart. Confidence is over here. Perfect. Perfect. And that also means that we have enough merit stamp cards to get that last little row unlocked. So that's nice. Three pies on a bone, thank you. Alright, nope, nope, nope. Get out. We're getting out of here. We're going to Yule. We're getting out of here, we're going to Yule. It almost sounds like I'm saying Yale, but I mean, I'm definitely not saying Yale. But it's like, it almost sounds like I'm saying Yale, I don't know. I don't know what I was trying to say there. It's just you. There are three errands for me to do in here, though. So let me actually accept those. And then we can do those along the way. Castaway Cove? Oh, you just need a snazzy swimsuit from Castaway Cove. That should be easy. We can go do that easily. We can go do that later. Oh, it's you guys again. You need something? What do you need this time, huh? Belief? I think we have that. Oh, there's a chest right in front of me too, and I just never saw it. There's a chest right in front of me. I'm gonna unlock that. Belief. And then I still have a bit of restraint to give to someone, whoever needs it. Whoever's gonna need it can take it. Alright, yada 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 yada. I don't care about what you have to say. I completely don't care about what you have to say. Oh hey, that's another stamp card we got. No! Let me get this chest. There we go. Hey, a phoenix feather. Nice. There's someone in this house. What do you need, dude? What do you need? Is it you? It's you. Oh, is it belief? Do you need belief? Oh, no, he's restraint. Oh, perfect! That is absolutely perfect. I have exactly what you need, good sir. I have exactly what you need. Oh, that is perfect. That is absolutely perfect. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. All right, let's get out of here. Let's get out of here and actually continue on with the story of this game, shall we? That's the main reason we're here. Oh, there's another thing here. We're Springlock. I'll gladly take that. Ooh, another blunt gem. That's the second one I've got now. Well, the first one I got from a quest, so I don't know if that counts. But let's actually... let me get the last upgrade and then unlock the third row. And then we'll continue on with the story. So I can show you guys... Nope. Alright, let's buy you. But we never really use it. But yeah, this is the last row. Jack of Hearts, Jack Amend All, which this is going to be nice. The more you explore, the more you restore. That's going to be nice. Further increases the amount of experience gained, reduces the amount of magical power required to reform spells, trick shots, whatever. Allows you to terrify your enemies even more, causes them to drop rare and valuable items. And this, Jack the Giant Killer, unlocks Oliver's full potential as a wizard and a hero. This is the one I was talking about that might be a good idea to get, because that increases your MP and your HP by 100. So, I think what we're going to do now is just save up. We're gonna save up a bunch of merit cards, merit stamp cards, and... hopefully before we go face off against Shadar, we'll have at least 8 merit stamp cards filled out, so we can get that 100 boost. Or that's the plan, and if that doesn't work out, we'll toss the cards into something else. But, anyway, so apparently Oliver here has a plan, a fan, not a plan. Oliver here has a fan in the form of, Professor Tabitha, who's apparently been writing about all of our journeys that we've done. And she apparently knows that we're here in search for stone to restore Mornstar. I don't know how she knows that, considering that, I'm pretty sure Mornstar is a thing of legend. So, I mean, I guess she's an archaeologist, so maybe she does know a thing or two about legends. Especially considering there's a stone hidden here. So. The stones were entrusted to his most faithful followers in order to prevent the wand's power from falling into the wrong hands. The creature we fought on Tombstone, it's possible. That's possible. That's completely possible, but I don't know if that counts. One of these followers of the stone they were entrusted with is in the cave beyond his village known as the Glittering Grotto. That is exactly where the map of the stones was pointing to. And two, actually, I somewhat forgot what I was going to say, but the Glittering Grotto is the next dungeon that we have to go through. I really like the Glittering Grotto. I think it's probably one of my favorite dungeons in this game, if not the favorite dungeon in this game. I really love the Glittering Grotto, and I don't know what it is about it that makes me like it so much, but, you know, it's just one of those things, you know, you don't really know why exactly you love it, but you really do. So, you know, but to enter the Glittering Grotto, you do need permission from the village's elder, and apparently he's out of town or something. Is he out of town, or is he just at a meeting somewhere in town? Either way, we can't exactly go into the Glittering Grotto just yet. So we need to go spend the night at the Cat's Cradle. Again, we need to go spend the night at the Cat's Cradle again. Which I believe costs about 250 guilders. I believe this costs 250 guilders, which is not exactly cheap, but we have more than enough money to take care of that. I'm gonna drop these guys off into the reserve because I don't need you. And then we'll just go sleep at the we'll just go sleep for the night. And then tomorrow we'll meet up with the village elder. It's 240. Okay, I was close. 250, 240, I was close. And now we got a couple of new pages in here about the Winter Wonderland. I don't even know if this place is called a Winter Wonderland. I'm just calling it a Winter Wonderland. I don't even know if that's what this place is called. It could be called something else. I don't know. We'll have to check the Wizard's Companion for that. And oh, there's another dream happening.
Well, well, it is you, the famous Alicia. To what do I owe this pleasure? I see. So you have come to do battle. How very unwise. And you a great sage. What do you hope to achieve? You know that all magic is powerless in my presence. Foolish girl, I have just the place for you. A prison of eternal darkness.
Crikey, sounds like a proper stinger of a dream, Ollie boy.
It was... Shadar was there. And Mom, she was...
Well, it's not really your mom, is it, Oliver? Yeah, it wasn't your mom, was it? It was Alicia.
Alicia, of course. I guess it was, huh? Sorry, everybody. We will save her. We have to.
Of course we flippin' do. It's the whole reason we're on this journey, ain't it? Yeah, right. Great. Glad we've cleared that up. Can we go see the village elder now?
Yeah, we best get going. Oh, that's a nice lady who runs at the inn, and she said his house is over by that big frozen pond way back at the village there.
Before we go do that, I'm gonna take this. I'll take a free cheeseburger, and I'll take some guilders, or a Nyxbegon. Actually, I'll take the Nyxbegon. The Nyxbegon might come in handy. But yeah, you know, it's kind of weird, don't you think? I would think that it's weird that Oliver's having dreams about what happened between Shadar and Alicia when he's not really connected to either of them. You know? I wouldn't say that he's definitely not connected to Shadar, and I wouldn't say he's very connected to Alicia either. The only connection that they've had is that his mom was her soulmate, apparently. So, that's a connection, but if his mom was her soulmate, why would he be having dreams about her, you know? It's that kind of thing. Anyways, this is the village elder. We are the ones heading into the Glittering Grotto. If you could help us out, please.
Don't worry about that, man. Kids like Ollie Boy love a bit of snow, ain't it?
Mm-hmm. It seems you are determined to go no matter what I'm saying. Am I thinking correctly?
I guess you are, sir.
Anyway, so he's gonna open up the gate for us, and I'm pretty sure he's gonna hand us some clothes so that we don't freeze to death. Am I right?
Oh, Tiny, this is proper cozy, like.
Yep. I mean, we would kind of freeze to death if we didn't have those, you know? But we got a set of winter clothes to keep ourselves warm. Or, you know, quote-unquote, keep ourselves warm. I'm pretty sure we could have kept ourselves warm with just a bit of fireball, you know? I'm like, we literally have a fire... Wait, what? Where am I going? I'm going up this way. Where am I going? But yeah, no, I'm pretty sure we could have kept ourselves warm with fireball, you know? I don't see why we couldn't just cast fireball or just hold it at, like, the tip of our wand. And, you know, do that. But speaking of... Well, not really speaking of anything, I have to go down and around. I have to go down and around this way. But, since we're out here, I'm gonna run to this guy, and I'm gonna show off one of the creatures that Derwin needs, which is a Sasquatch. So, Derwin needs one of these guys for his, research. Why, I'm not exactly too sure. Does he need a Sasquatch or a Sasquatch? I don't know if he needs a Sasquatch or a Sasquatch. Which one does he need? Yo, hold on, wait, which one does he need? I don't know which one he needs. Well, either way, it doesn't matter because they're dead. But I don't know if he needs a Sasquatch or a Sasquatch. I guess we'll figure that out once we get to him, but... I would like to know which one he needs. Oh, I didn't even see you. Which is weird, considering... Oh, this is another one! The Lotus Bubbard! This is another one of the creatures that Derwin needs for his experiments. Not experiments. Derwin is not experimenting on these creatures. He is doing research. But the Lotus Bubbard is another creature that you would like to see. If we could actually get one of them. It'd be nice if we could actually get one of them, you know? That'd be nice. There's only one left. Come on, guys. Go on. Just die already. Actually, you know what? Don't die. I need Esther to befriend you. Or not. Okay. I kind of need Esther to... Okay. Cool. Yeah. But anyway, those are two of the creatures that we need. I think the third one that we need, I think, I don't know which one that is. I genuinely cannot remember which one that is. So, I guess we'll figure that out when we get there. But I'm gonna purposely get into fights with a couple of these guys just so I have a chance of befriending them / recruiting them. I don't know what you would call it. Befriending them, recruiting them. Same thing in this circumstance, I suppose. But, oh, ear splitter. I shouldn't do too much. Oh, never mind, it did 53 damage. Shouldn't do too much, I say. And then it does freaking 53 damage. Someone's using ear splitter. That shouldn't do too much, right? Oh yeah, no, that didn't do that much. That definitely didn't do that much at all. Alright, how are you not dead yet? How are you not dead yet? I feel like you should definitely be dead by now. There we go. Whoa, 23 MP from a single glim? Let's go. Let's go. 23 MP from a single... Ooh, a moon drop and a moon crystal, nice. I'm gonna spam the A button. We're actually pretty close to Glittering Grotto. It's actually right over there. You can see it. You can see the big, like, jaw. Like, you can see the big jaw like that. You can see a little guard person over there. There is something we can get down there. I'm not gonna go get it because I'd have to go all the way around for that. But, hey, you're... So, normally, if you came... by here before going to talk to the village elder, he would have been in your way and would have refused you entry. And so, you know, you would have made this journey all the way for nothing. You have to go to Yule no matter what to talk to the guy and to get these clothes. So, the Glittering Grotto, Hall of the Mountain King. But yeah, nope. I do agree with Esther. that it actually looks great in here. Like, I really like it. I really like how this place looks. But Oliver's keeping everybody on track from complaining, or keeping them from complaining. Or, I say he's keeping them from complaining, but complain they will, no matter what. I'm going to heal up real quick. I'm not going to save, though. Although, maybe I should. Maybe I should have saved. No, we'll be fine. We'll be okay. We'll be perfectly fine, right, guys? Right, guys? We'll be perfectly fine. So, yeah, because we are in a ice kind of place, I think it's safe to assume that fire is a good spell to have here. And, you know, considering, you know, Fireball takes the least MP out of all our magic spells, I think it's good that we're doing, like, a decent amount of damage for a low amount of MP. But we're also taking a lot of damage, because the enemies here are significantly stronger than ones you may have faced so far in the past. These guys are pretty damn strong. So, if you're underleveled, take extreme caution while you're in here. And if you're not underleveled, I'd still recommend taking some caution while you're in here. But maybe you don't have to be as precautioned as others, you know? Is precaution the word? Is that a word? I feel like I just made up a word. Hey, nope. Mighty, get back here. Mighty, get back here. There we go. Ice Queen. Wait, we're not... The Turbandit's not even dead. Why am I targeting the Ice Queen? Okay, now... A Turbandit. That's not a Turbandit. That is a Turban Legend.
We did it!
Also, I got 0 MP from that. I'm assuming Oliver's just leveled up. Yep. So, kind of a bad time. Well, oh my goodness, Swain. Jeez, Swain. Swain's not doing so well. Oh my god. Yeah, Swain's not gonna do so well in here, is he? Oh well. Just try your best, Swain. I guess that's really the best I can... That's really the most I could say, is just try your best and don't die. There's another ear splitter coming our way, but I couldn't block against that, so... Oh, is a dragon poisoned? Is a dragon poisoned? I saw a poison. Swain is poisoned. Swain! I literally just said don't die on me, Swain. Ooh! I don't know if that's the guy that we need. I'm not 100% sure if that's... Oh, I hate you. Oh, no, it's not! It's not, because the guy that we need is, like... The guy that we need is someone that has snow on top of his head, right? Oh! But we can get the Sasquatch! Oh, wow, perfect! Oh, that's perfect! Yeah, I just remembered, the guy that we need is the guy who has... is the one that has snow on top of his head, so the Sasquatch is what we need. Lucky us, we got both the Sasquatch and the Sasquatch! We'll keep the Sasquatch, call you Squishy, keep the Sasquash, call you Squashy. And then, hi dude, there's no hidden passageway behind this wall, are you sure about that? Oh. Are you sure? It definitely feels like there's a hidden passageway behind that wall. Definitely feels like that. Speaking of hidden passageway, well... We'll talk more about those when we get to there. Oh, there's a treasure chest over there. Hi! I do want to go get that treasure chest, though.
Let's go!
I was gonna say Oliver sounds like a little kid. Momentarily forgetting that he is, in fact, a little kid. Swain needs a heal. Okay, Swain got the heal. Okay. I did not pay attention to Swain's HP outside of battle. Holy crud. Conflagrate. Whoa. Holy crud. That knocked out almost everybody here. Holy crud. Why are you coming? Drippy! Drippy, you stupid fairy, you can't get in my way. Don't get in my way, Drippy. You're gonna make me take damage. I don't appreciate that. What I get? A frosty flan. Well, that's not very helpful now, is it? Let me heal myself and Swain up, because my goodness, did we take some hits there. But we're doing alright. Oh man, at this rate, I don't know if we're even gonna reach like the first save stone before the end of this video.
Let's do it!
I don't know why I'm mocking Ollie. I'm gonna be honest, I have no idea why I'm mocking him. Like, he's a kid. He hasn't started puberty yet. He's gonna sound like an 11-year-old, because he is an 11-year-old. That makes you think. A lot of people, like, imagine Red from Pokemon with, like, a lower voice. But if you think about it, Red from Pokemon, he's 11 in the game. He's not gonna have a low voice. He's 11. He's a literal... I mean, granted, like, in the later games, once he's, like, 15 or 16... 15 or 16? No, in Pokemon... In Gold and Silver, he's, like, what, 14? So maybe you have a bit of a deeper voice there, but, like, my voice still stands. A lot of people would imagine Red with, like, a lower voice, but the kid's 11. He's an 11-year-old kid. He's not gonna have a low voice. He's gonna sound like a child, because that's exactly what he is. But hey, Dragly can metamorphose. No, let's definitely do that. Let's definitely do that. Nope. Creature cage. You need a jumbo star drop. Do I have one of those? I do. A drag muffin or a bedrag? I think we're going drag muffin. We don't have a lot of fire guys here. And we're definitely gonna need a fire guy for what's coming up next. Oh, a Dragumuffin? A Dragumuffin? Whatever. Same deal. There's a thingy here. Oh, wow. I jumped and we still got into a battle with you. I'm literally in the air and you're still choosing to pick a fight with me? Dude. You serious, dude? Nope, that's Frostbite. No, oh my god. Alright. What do you mean that hurt? Well, I say that, and yet Oliver is literally at 65 health. So I guess it did hurt. Just not as much as Oliver was thinking, because he said that hurt like four times during that. He said that hurt four times during that snowstorm. It did not hurt that much, Oliver. I can guarantee you that it did not hurt that much. Anyway, are you gonna take care of that guy? I think you could take care of him. I think you guys could take care of him. I'm gonna save my MP here. You guys took care of him pretty well. That Griffles is also at his final stage, am I right? I believe Griffles is at his final stage of evolution. Metamorphosis. Oh, why did you have to respawn? Why did you have to respawn? I don't know if I can get past you. Nope. I want to make progress today. Ah. I want to make progress today, I say. I want to make progress today. I want to at least get to the first, like, save point inside of this dungeon. And that means not fighting you guys every turn of the way. I can't keep fighting you guys every turn of the way. Holy crud, Swain's about to die. Swain, are you okay? Oh, not another one. Okay, this might be Swain's death. I think that's the death of Swain. Yep, that is the death of Swain. And I'm getting hit by something else now, too? What the hell? Oh, apparently I did not get hit by something else. One Sasquatch left. Swain, how are you yelling when you're unconscious? How are you yelling out a war cry when you're literally unconscious, Swain? Please level up. Oh, come on, Swain. Swain, you're killing me here. I mean, I guess I'm the one that's killing you, but, like, come on, Swain. You're alright, but now I'm out of MP. So, oh no! Okay, I'd rather find a Trevandy than a Sasquatch. Oh my god, there's a Sasquatch in here.
I
literally said I would rather fight the bandit than the Sasquatch, and then I run into a Sasquatch anyway. There's a snowstorm happening as well. So that's just good timing all around. Two ear splitters right after another? Come on. God, I have to heal myself. I have to heal myself. I know Swain's dying. I'm aware. Oh, wait, I can recruit. Let me get the Turban Legend while Swain and Oliver fight and hopefully not die. Please don't die, you guys. Please don't die. Alright, whoop. Alright, come on. Let's take care of you. And then we'll go take care of the other Turban Legend that's right over here. Oh my god, I'm doing no physical damage whatsoever. Swain is literally just like an inch away from death. Not even an inch. Swain is so close to death right there. But hey, he gets to level up, so that's a free heal for Swain. That is a free heal for Swain. I'll keep the Turban Legend. Ledgely? Out of all the names you could have given it, you gave it the name Ledgely? Seriously? What? Oh, hey! Sucks to suck, buddy. You can't climb up slopes. Okay, I need you to go away. You can't... Bro. Literally, go away. You can't just stay... You can't just camp the bottom of the slope, man. Go away. There we go. Oh my gosh. You can't camp the bottom of the slope, dude. That's not fair. Being a camper is not exactly a fun way to play the game, you know. A pouch of Phoenix Breath. Nice. I was gonna say I'll show you guys what that does later, but I don't think we'll... Oh, dear. Jump, jump, jump. There you go.
Phew.
You're fine. You guys are fine. You jumped right in time, so I think you're alright. But I am out of usable MP now. So I think it's a good idea to avoid as many battles as we possibly can for the time being. Though how much... Okay. I was gonna say, though, how much I can avoid, I am unsure. Like this one right here. I cannot avoid that. The guy spotted me. I had nowhere to run because I was being chased from behind as well. So, there was really nothing I could do there. Oh, I forgot our HP situation is what it is. So let's just try our... Oh my gosh. Oliver needs a heal. Nope, he needs provisions. Yeah, just take the sandwich. Just take the sandwich, Oliver. Okay, who's hitting me with the snowball? Oh, ear splitter! Ouch. Alright, let's take care of this Sasquatch, and let's take care of this Sasquatch. All-out attack on this guy, please. Oh my god. That griffin, man. This griffin is a lifesaver. This griffin is an absolute lightsaber, man. A lightsaber? No, he's a lifesaver. He's not a lightsaber. Why did I say lightsaber? Why did I say lightsaber? No, but really, why did I say lightsaber? Hello to you, here at Glitter and Glitter, there are hidden passageways, there as walls are looking strange, yes? Yeah, like these walls that are like somewhat reflective, you can just pass right through them. And you can tell which walls you can pass through, because they have like a somewhat different sheen to them. You guys can kind of see that this one's kind of more reflective. They have a different shine to them, so you can pass right through. And we come out over here, which is like near the beginning. No, 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 no. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. Are you following me in here? Oh my god, you followed me in here. I didn't think you could follow me in here. What the hell? I didn't think that wild familiars could follow you into the... I didn't know. But whoa.
Mom! Could this be the place?
It could. The Maw of the Mountain King seems an apt hiding place for the visionary magic of the ancients.
This power to save souls, could it really be here? If you could only find it, we might stand a chance of defeating the Dark Djinn. That's
the old Emperor.
It is, huh? Why would he and my mom be here?
That ain't your mom. That's a great sage, Alicia.
Crikey, it's been a while.
Alicia? Of course, she was in my dream. She looks so much like her.
So the old emperor spent his time hanging around with pretty young sages, did he? It's all right for some.
Swine! Is this really the time for your lewd comments?
Why are we seeing visions of the No, we're all seeing that!
Ah, now I remember. Nah, man, we ain't seeing things.
Or not?
Oh, it was a tidy while back. Searching all over she was, Alicia, I mean, for some ancient spell or other. That must have been the conversation they had back then. Could have been anything else, certain of it I am.
I don't quite understand.
What's there not to understand? We just saw a flashback of the past.
The only question is why. So that was the great sage Alicia, Mom's soulmate. It won't be much longer now. We will save you, I promise. Oliver. Sorry, everybody. Come on, let's go get this stone.
Yeah, why we're seeing flashbacks of the past here, I have absolutely no idea. I need to make a bridge. Oh no, I need to use Pulse. I don't have any MP though. So let me drink some coffee. Because I need MP. That's not the break button. There we go. I need Pulse for that, I believe. Yup. There's some icicles up top that we can knock over with Pulse. And suddenly, we have a bit of a path. A bit of a path. No, we have a path. We have a path to cross. And then over here, we need Fireball. Which is right here. Not the alcohol, the spell. Also, if Oliver can control his fire that well, I still don't see why he can't just summon, like, a ball of fire and use that to keep himself and his team warm. You know what I mean? Oh, no. No. No, you're gonna catch me. Damn it. I forgot that those things are actually really fast. Oh my god, we start off with two snowstorms? Did I see two snowstorms right there? What the hell? Okay, Oliver's dead. Is my entire team dead? Holy shit, Esther, how are you alive? Holy shit, Esther. Oh my god, Esther, how are you alive? It doesn't matter how, actually. I don't care how. We need to run. We need to run. It really is. Two of the party members just died. We're not. No. Oh, shoot. I forgot you respawn. Okay, I'm gonna come over by here. And I think this is a safe spot for now. Yeah, this is a safe spot right now. Oh, man. While we're here, I'm gonna go through here. Melt the icicles that we just dropped earlier. And we're gonna go get that chest that's right there. And hopefully that's something good. And while I'm back here, I'm also gonna heal. Because, oh my god, we got a vial of Sage's Secret. We got two vials of Sage's Secret. Let's go. Anyways, you take a couple sandwiches. You take a couple of sandwiches. That's my last sandwiches. Also, Phoenix Breath. That's gonna come in handy. That is gonna come in super handy. All I have are cheeseburgers. Okay, cool. I think we're at a decent amount of HP right now. I do want to give Oliver a bit of MP just in case we need some magic in the future. I'm not gonna use up all of his magic in fights, though. Can't do that. If I can avoid you, if at all, I want to avoid you. I want to avoid you. That's all there is to it. I want to avoid you the best I can, but I don't know if I have anything that can help me do that. I don't have anything that can help me do that. Alright, you're turned around, so I'm gonna take this opportunity to come this way. No, I know the ice is walking away. I know, there's a thing right behind us. I need to go. We need to go, go. Stop talking and just go. Come on, I wanna at least get to, like, a checkpoint area. Go! Okay. Whew. Okay, there's another one over there. But you're gonna turn around. Yes, you are. Okay, I'm gonna melt this one as well. We're getting a bit sidetracked, but the stuff in this these chests are actually gonna come in handy. Believe me. Or at least most that vial of Sage of Secret is definitely gonna come in handy. I don't know if the chocolate bonbon's gonna come in very handy, but the Sage of Secret definitely will. Can I get past you without fighting you? The answer is no. Ah, oh, man.
Stay calm now.
Honestly, I'm just gonna run. I'm just gonna run. Ah, shoot. Darkness beckons. No. Oh, wait, no. That's not. No. Run away.
Run. It's too risky.
Yeah, it definitely is. It's actually not too risky. I could have taken them if I actually fought them. I could have taken them. But my goal right now is to at least get to the first. There's this freaking Sasquatch! Oh, we're quite a ways away, man. No, I can outrun you, though. I can't outrun you, though, so I'll fight you. But I can't outrun the guy that's behind me. Here's the thing, is that it's not too risky to fight these guys. It really isn't. We can take these guys if we tried. I just don't want to fight them right now. I really don't want to fight them right now. Because this video is going to end up way too long if I fight every enemy that's along the way. This video is going to end up really long, but I can't get away from this fight! Esther's about to die and I can't get out of this fight. Come on, Esther's literally dead on the floor. Come on, I just want to get to that save stone that I know is in here. I know there's a save stone in here. Where is it? I know, oh God, turn around. Thank you. No! Oh my God, how far are you going to chase? I'd rather fight you. Oh, you're gone. Oh, thank goodness. Okay, let me heal up Esther, because I have a feeling we're gonna get into a fight before we get to that next save stone. Keep going. Keep moving. There's also another wall that I can pass through right over here. I can go into here. And this takes us to a chest. Which, oh, a snowball jump, nice. Okay, let's see if I can't go around this way. No! No, oh God, this is a dead end. No! Oh! At this point, it's quicker just to fight these guys.
Let's go! Here goes!
Honestly, at this point, it's quicker just to fight these guys. The amount of time I spent running away from that last fight, I could have defeated all those enemies in that time. You know, though the snowstorms are not very much appreciated, so if y'all could stop with the snowstorms, Esther just took 102 damage. Esther really just took 102 damage from that, my goodness. Alright, well the Turbo Legends are dead, so now we just gotta beat the Sasquatch. Which, considering it's a Sasquatch and not a Sasquatch, I think it'll be easier to defeat. Am I right? Yep. Nice job, Mighty. Yeah, it is definitely faster to fight these guys instead of just running away from all the fights. It takes so long to run away from fights. Because it's not a guaranteed runaway. Also, I really ran myself into a dead end there. Not fighting you! Because there it is! Oh, finally! Finally! Oh my gosh. This is literally where I wanted to make it. I just wanted to make it to here. I'm gonna drop off a couple of these familiars. I'm gonna drop you off. I'm gonna keep you with me because Derwin needs to see you for some reason. Whew! I just wanted to get to this point. That's all I wanted to do. Okay, but no, we're done. That is all for this episode. Whew. We got a bit of stuff to go in the Glittering Grotto, but we'll do that next time. So, I hope you guys have enjoyed. Like, subscribe, and I'll see you all next time. Bye-bye!